إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, as is our condition, our human condition, we are constantly finding ourselves in a state of struggle. Constantly finding ourselves challenged and tested. We are challenged and tested by ourselves a lot of the time. Our weaknesses, our inability. We are challenged and tested trying to avoid sin and transgression against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes, with the grace of Allah, we are victorious over our weaknesses. And sometimes we are defeated. Brothers and sisters, this challenge, I should say, this battle between good and evil, it is a very, very old and ancient battle. This is an ancient battle that began the beginning of mankind. The beginning when man was created. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam alayhi salatu wa salam with his two hands. And then he commanded the angels and all that were present to prostrate to Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمِ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبَلِيسَ كَانَ مِنَ الْجِنِّ فَفَسَقَ عَنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, what's translated to mean, and mentioned when we said to the angels, prostrate to Adam. When he said to the angels, prostrate to Adam, and they prostrated except for Iblis, who was from the jinn, and he departed from the command of his Lord. Iblis, which is also known as Ash-Shaytan, the Satan, amongst the angels, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he ordered the angels to prostrate. Right? There are two types of prostration that are done or recognized in Islam. One, it's called sujood al-tahiyya. It's a greeting or ikram, or a way to honor someone. And this happened twice. It happened for Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, and it happened for the Prophet Yusuf. These were the only times in which that was legislated for a creation to prostrate to another created thing. And then there's the sujood that we all know and perform, and that is sujood al-ibadah, which is the prostration done for worship. The prostration that is done only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this case, the angels were ordered to prostrate to Adam, greeting him and honoring him and all those that were present. But Iblis, he turned away. He did not join the ranks of the angels. Those distinguished creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that have been created praising Allah azza wa jal. So why is it that the jinn, this jinni here, Iblis, he refused and turned away from the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah azza wa jalla says in the Quran, قَالَ مَا مَنَعَكَ أَلَّا تَسْجُدَ إِذْ أَمَرْتُكَ. He says, and what has prohibited you from prostrating when you have been ordered? قَالَ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْهُ خَلَقَتَنِي مِنْ نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ طِينٍ. Iblis, he responded to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying that I am better than him. I am better than Adam. You have created me from fire, whereas you created him from clay. You created him from dirt. Iblis, he began to rationalize the command of Allah. Look here, this was the first step which led Iblis away from the truth. He began to try and rationalize and use his own logic against the infinite wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why must I prostrate myself when I'm made of fire? Fire, it seemingly appears to be better than clay. So why should I humble myself and lower myself when I'm better in standing, when I'm better in creation? So he began to rationalize the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he became proud of that rationale and that logic. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمْ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. In this verse Allah says, and mention, when we said to the angels, prostrate before Adam. And so they prostrated except for Iblis. He refused and he was arrogant. And he became from the disbelievers. The arrogance led him so far astray, denying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command, denying the commandments and the ordainments of Allah azza wa jal. Brothers and sisters, he was an outcast. He was made an outcast and he was cursed, and he was given respite until the day of judgment. He was given time, is what that means. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for time. What did he do with that time? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him time. What did he do? What is he using that time for? When you look in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-A'raf, verses number 16 and 17, قَالَ فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ صِرَاطَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what means Satan said, because you have put me in error, blaming Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his own misdeed, you have put me in error, I will surely sit and wait for them on your straight path. I will wait for those who are on your straight path, and I will come to them in every direction. I will come to them in every way, from before them and from behind them, on the right of them and on the left of them, and you will not find that most of them are grateful to you. He's using this time to draw those who are faithful away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, this is our struggle. This is the struggle that we face. We are up against an enemy. We are up against an enemy full of hatred and spite. And this enemy, Iblis, a shaytan, he is seasoned. He is a veteran. He is a professional at his job. He has been at it more than you can imagine. Longer than you can trace your family lineage, the shaytan has been at his task, trying to draw people away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he is a master of deception and trickery, a master at lying and deceit. And it comes from all sides. The shaytan, if he cannot get you in one way, if he cannot approach you in one way, then he will certainly try in many, many different ways. From every angle, he is looking for a weakness. He is looking for something. Something to pull you away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hijr, verses number 39 and 40, قَالَ رَبِّي بِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَأُزَيِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Shaitani says, my Lord, Shaytan, he says, my Lord, Rabbi, my Creator. Even the shaytan recognizes this fact. Of course he would recognize this fact. He says, Rabbi bima aghwaytani la uzayyinanna lahum ma fil ard. La uzayyinanna lahum fil ard. He says, and I will beautify for them. I will beautify for them what is in the earth, what is in this world. I will beautify and make attractive to them the delights of this world in hopes that they will be misled. وَلَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. And by this I will lead all of them astray. I will lead all of them astray. إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ مِنْهُمُ الْمُخْلِصِينَ. except for your sincere servants, except for those who are sincere in finding the truth, except for those who are sincere in finding the truth and then acting upon that truth. Brothers and sisters, the enemy is looking to draw us away in any means possible, by any means necessary, in any way possible. He will cover and conceal the truth, regardless of the cost. He's not playing by any rules. He's not playing by any type of rules here. Right? We are the ones trying to live our lives by some rules, but the shaitan, he's not playing by those rules. And we can see one of the greatest victories of the shaitan over mankind. It happened during the time of Nuh, alayhi salatu wasalam. The trickery and the deceit that he uses. When you learn about the history, when you know your enemy, you know some of the tactics that he will use to deceive you and lead you astray, and therefore you are better prepared in dealing with that. Here we can see one of the narrations Imam al-Tabari, rahimahullah, mentions in a tafsir from Surah An-Nur. He says, عن محمد بن قيس قال كانوا قوما صالحين من بني آدم وكان لهم أتباع يقتدون بهم. He said that these people were, there was a group of them that were righteous. Righteous and pious people from the children of Adam. And they had people that were imitating and following them, this group of righteous people. فَلَمَّا مَاتُوا قَالَ أَصْحَابُهُمُ الَّذِينَ كَانُوا يَقْتَدُونَ بِهِمْ لَوْ سَوَّرْنَاهُمْ كَانَ أَشْوَقَ لَنَا إِلَى الْعِبَادَةِ. He says, when these righteous people passed away and died, they said, if we were only to make pictures of them and make statues of them, it would be more encouraging for us to remind us of worship. Because these righteous people, they prayed to Allah Azza wa Jal. These righteous people, they fasted. They did righteous good deeds and stayed away from prohibitions. So when they passed away, their followers, those that were learning from them and benefiting from their presence, they said, if we only were to make statues and pictures, we could hang them up on our walls. We could put them in our city centers, and when we walk by them, we'll be reminded of their righteousness and encouraged to be righteous ourselves. We'll be encouraged to be righteous ourselves. It goes on. فَصَوَّرُوهُمْ. So they did so. They made pictures and they made statues. فَلَمَّا مَاتُوا جَاءَ آخَرُونَ. And when they passed away, that generation that created those statues and pictures, another generation came. دَبَّ إِلَيْهِمْ إِبْلِيسِ. And then Iblis, he came to them. But he didn't just come openly. It says he creeped to them. He crawled to them. Some people say it could possibly even be like slithering to them, crawling on all fours like a snake, sneaking up to them. فَقَالَ إِنَّمَا كَانُوا يَعْبُدُونَهُمْ وَبِهِمْ يُسْقَوْنَ الْمَطَرْ فَعَبَدُوهُمْ. He said to these people, the next generation, because they didn't know what was the purpose of these pictures and statues. They only knew that when they saw their grandparents and great-grandparents pass by them, they would begin to pray. They would begin to act righteous. He said, the shaitan, he said, they used to worship those things. Those were their gods. Those were their idols. And they used to pray to them to bring about the rain. And so that generation began to worship those statues and pictures, began to worship those false gods who were originally human beings just like they were. The deceit of shaitan. Brothers and sisters, out of ignorance, these people were led astray. Out of their own ignorance, they were led astray. They did not know the purpose of those statues and pictures. They were unaware of that purpose. They were ignorant. And the shaitan will leverage your ignorance against you. If you do not know, he will use your ignorance as a tool, as a weapon to destroy you. And it's for this reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends prophets and messengers. He sends us prophets and messengers so that they can guide us to knowledge. They can guide us to truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ كَمَا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى نُوحٍ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ مِنْ بَعْدِ وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ وَالْأَسْبَاطِ وَعِيسَى وَأَيُّوبَ وَيُونُسَ وَهَارُونَ وَسُلَيْمَانَ وَآتَيْنَا دَاوُودَ زَبُورًا. Indeed, we have revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as we revealed to Noah and the prophets after him, and we revealed to Abraham, Ishmael, Isaac, Jacob, the descendants, Jesus, Job, Jonah, Aaron, and Solomon, and to David we gave the Psalms. وَرُسُلًا قَدْ قَصَصْنَاهُمْ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ قَبَلْ وَرُسُلٌ لَمْ نَقْصُصْهُمْ عَلَيْكَ وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا. And we sent messengers about whom we have related to you their stories. And before you there were messengers that we did not relate to you their stories, and Allah spoke to Musa. He spoke to Moses directly with speech. رُسُلًا مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنذِرِينَ لِأَلَّا يَكُونَ لِلنَّاسِ عَلَى اللَّهِ حُجَّةٌ بَعْدَ الرُّسُلِ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَزِيزًا حَكِيمًا. To conclude these ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and we sent messengers as bringers of good tidings. We sent messengers as bringers of good news and as warners, so that mankind will not have an argument against Allah, so that mankind cannot say, we did not know, we were led astray, but you did not send us a sign. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent us prophets and messengers to every nation to guide us back into the light of knowledge, from the darkness of ignorance, the most deadly tool of the shaitan. And ever exalted is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in might and wise. Brothers and sisters, guidance has been given to us. Knowledge, it has been conveyed to us. And it is up to us to make a decision. It is there. It is present. The prophets and messengers, they have been sent. Their messages have been conveyed to us. And it is up to us to take that message and apply it to our lives. First, we have to learn what that message is and what it contains. Either way, either we do this or we do that, it will have been based upon evidence. If we choose to go to route A for passing, or we choose to go to route F for failing, it will be done based upon evidence. It will not be excusable on the Day of Judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, لِيَهْلِكَ مَنْ هَلَكَ عَنْ بَيِّنَةً وَيَحْيَى مَنْ حَيَّ عَنْ بَيِّنَةً وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَسَّمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. That those who perished through disbelief would perish upon evidence, and those who lived in faith would live upon evidence. That has been made clear to us, the right and the wrong. It has been made clear to us by these great men of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these great men of God Almighty, the messengers and the prophets. It is only through the guidance of these messengers, brothers and sisters, that we will find the path to peace. It is only through the guidance of the prophets and messengers that we will find our path to peace. The tighter we cling to that guidance, the tighter we cling to the guidance of the prophets and messengers, the weaker the grip of the shaitan will be. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضاه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد. Brothers and sisters, over the history of mankind, there have been a large number of prophets and messengers that have come to mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent prophet and messenger after prophet and messenger, one after the other, as he says in the Quran, ثُمَّ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا تَتْرَى. And then we sent our messengers in succession. وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةِ رَسُولًا. And we have sent to every nation a messenger. We have sent to every nation a messenger. Brothers and sisters, up until the time of Musa and Isa alayhim as-salatu was-salam, people were receiving the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through their prophets and messengers, looking for deliverance from the evil of the shaitan, the evil that their souls were plagued with. They were looking for the delivery of that message to bring about their deliverance. And they found it. And with the coming of these two mighty messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Moses and Jesus alayhi salatu wasalam, this was a great news to mankind, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would seal his message, complete faith for all of humanity. perfecting their way of life. It was a great blessing for all of mankind, but it was a terrible warning for Shaytan. When the Shaytan, the Satan, he became aware of this. He stepped up his efforts. He became aware of this how? How would the Shaytan know of this information? From the time of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam to the time of Jesus, peace be upon him. He knew of this because it was present in their books. He says, those who follow the messenger, the unlettered prophet, whom they find written in what they have of the Torah and the gospel. Written in the Torah and in the Bible. It is information about a coming prophet and messenger, a final seal of that messengership. يَأْمُرُونَ يَأْمُرُهُمْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَاهُمْ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَيُحِلُّ لَهُمُ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَيُحَرِّمُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْخَبَائِثِ. Who enjoins upon them what is right and forbids for them what is wrong and makes lawful for them the good and prohibits for them the evil. وَيَضَعُ عَنْهُمْ إِسْرَهُمْ وَالْأَغْلَالَ الَّتِي كَانَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ. And he relieves them of their burden and their shackles. He relieves them of their burden and their shackles, their chains. The shackles and chains of darkness and ignorance. فَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِهِ وَعَزَّرَهُ وَنَصَرَهُ وَاتَّبَعُوا النُّورَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ مَعْهُ أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues, he says, so they who have believed in him, honored him, supported him, and followed the light which was sent down with him, it is those who will be the successful. The coming of a final prophet and messenger. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a messenger who was found in the scriptures of the past, the Torah and the Injil, that would come calling people to that which is good and prohibiting from that which is evil, that will bring relief to their life and relieve them of their shackles and burdens. So whoever follows him, honors him, supports him, those are the successful people. The Shaytan, he heard of this news. And he did not want mankind to follow after this final prophet and messenger. So he stepped up with his army. Brothers and sisters, the Shaytan, he is not a lone enemy. He is not by himself, but he has an army of evil. There are shayateen amongst us. Not here, inshallah. But there are shayateen in our lives. When you think about it, in your life, you can probably remember someone who has wanted nothing but hardship for you. Someone who has wanted nothing but evil for you. Someone that is enticing you there, inviting you to lewdness, crudeness, and the disbelief in Allah Azza wa Jal. Someone, whether it be someone you know personally, someone you see on the television, someone you know at your office, someone you know at your school, who is inviting you to disbelief in Allah. From the army of the shayateen, there is man and there is jinn. The Shaytan, he leverages these people as agents to deceive one another from the truth. So he turned to these people. He turned to them, trying to pull them away, calling them to denial and disbelief. And this is something that happened after the time of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and Isa. This project of Shaytan, it happened to a point that the people were led so far astray. And this is something witnessed that we can see in recent history, that he took these people of Ahl Kitab, the people of the scripture, and led them so far away that they fell into idolatry of their own prophets and messengers. And it exceeded the point where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was displeased and disdained most of humanity. He was upset with most of humanity. This is a report that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Anna Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam qala dhata yawmin fi khutbati yawm al-jum'ah," when he was given the lecture on yawm al-jum'ah, "Ala inna Rabbi amarani an u'allimakum ma jahiltum mimma 'allamani yawmi hadha." He says, "Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded me to teach you that which you are ignorant of on this day." وَإِنِّي خَلَقْتُ عِبَادِي حُنَفَاءَ كُلَّهُمْ. He says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I have created my servants, all of them are righteous. All of them are righteous. وَإِنَّهُمْ أَتَتْهُمُ الشَّيَاطِينَ فَاجْتَالَتْهُمْ عَنْ دِينِهِمْ. And then the shayateen, they came to them and they diverted them away from the deen. They diverted them away from their true faith. وَحَرَّمَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ مَا أَحْلَلْتُ لَهُمْ. And they prohibited what I made permissible for them. وَأَمَرَتْهُمْ أَن يُشْرِكُوا بِي مَا لَمْ أُنَزِّلْ بِهِ سُلْطَانًا. And then they commanded them to associate partners with me. They commanded them to worship others besides me, and I gave them no right to do so. It began with sins and transgression. It began with small things. Brothers and sisters, the shaytan, he does not come to a person that prays and says, go commit zina, go fornicate. He does not come to a person that prays and tells him to go steal. A person that prays their five prayers, they are the furthest away from these. Not to say that it doesn't happen, of course. It happens for those that are just going through the motions. But a person who is sincere in their worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, shaytan cannot get to them in this manner. Not with the big things. He has to start with the little things. The shaytan has to begin with the little steps. As it says in the previous narration, Dabba ilayhim, that he creeps to them and crawls to them and begins to make that which is haram look halal. It's a small sin. It's a small thing. Just one word. One ill word, no big deal, no problem. And that escalates and it evolves. The shaytan will continue, he will not stop there. When he has got you to stop praying, he will not stop there. If he has gotten you to the point that you no longer pray, do not think that it is over, because his end result is that you turn away from Allah ultimately, and then you worship something in this creation. It happened to those that came before us. He wants you to make the ultimate sin, the unforgivable sin, which is shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa na'udhu billah, to associate partners in his worship. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went on this hadith. He says, وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ نَظَرَ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ فَمَقَتَهُمْ عَرَبَهُمْ وَعَجَمَهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he looked at the people on this earth and he was displeased. He disdained them, the Arab and the non-Arab. إِلَّا بَقَايَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ. Except for what remained, a small group of the people of the book, the Jews and the Christians. The majority of them had turned away so far, including the tribe of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that they had turned to worshiping idols. When you look at the history of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, they found in that time period that there was still remaining the faith of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, the monotheistic religion, believing and praying to Allah only. But the majority of them had turned away from that and taken idols, over 300 of them, to worship besides Allah Azza wa Jal. So when Allah looked at those people, he was despised. He found them to be despicable. Brothers and sisters, this is when the Prophet, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, it was to come and remove that disdain from mankind. It was to come and remove that anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from mankind. Brothers and sisters, this is one of our tests. This is one of our tests, one of our trials. It is to follow the last messenger of Allah Azza wa Jal. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that came to give us the last words of guidance. This is our trial, is to follow in his footsteps, to cling tightly to his guidance so that we can meet Allah Azza wa Jal and be pleased in the pleasure of Allah. Brothers and sisters, the shaytan, he will use whatever tool he can to keep you away from guidance. The shaytan will use whatever tool available to keep you away from guidance. Look at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his uncle Abu Talib, a supporter of Islam during his life, a supporter of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, even though he was faced with great pressure from his tribesmen. On his deathbed, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was there, encouraging him to say La ilaha illallah, to say this one word so that he can have an excuse with his Lord. Say this one word so that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam could intercede on his behalf. But what was it that the shaytan used to keep him from truth? His culture. His forefathers. his ancestors. This is what was used, this tool, to keep him from guidance. Are you going to turn away from your forefathers? Are you going to turn away from your culture? This was the case. This was the end of Abu Talib. This was the way that he died. He rejected the truth for his forefathers, for his ancestors, for the way things used to be done. This was how Shaytan was able to trick and deceive. And this happens all of the time. Brothers and sisters, we have to be aware of this. We have to be careful of this. We as people, not Muslims, we as human beings in this time, we have a great opportunity. We as human beings, all of mankind, Muslim and non-Muslim alike, we have the opportunity of a lifetime. There is no other group of people that share in this opportunity, and that is the honor of following the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The honor that is brought to you by holding on to the sunnah of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, following up from the previous verses, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا. Say, O Muhammad, I am indeed to you, mankind, the messenger of Allah. الَّذِي لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا هُوَ يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتِ. For him to whom belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth, there is no deity except him. He gives life and causes death. فَآمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ النَّبِيِّ الْأُمِّيِّ الَّذِي يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَكَلِمَاتِهِ وَاتَّبَعُوهُ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ. So believe in Allah and His Messenger, the unlettered prophet, who believes in Allah, who believes in Allah and in His words, and follow him. Follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam so that you may be guided. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna tiba'a wa arina al-batila batilan warzuqna ijtinaba ya muqallib al-qulub thabbit qulubana ala dinak. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin wa aqimis salah.